we are also providing a lot of information on our website and links also, as to which are the power plants, which are operative, non-operative, where the fuel, what is the fuel position. The CE is also giving that information. But we are also trying to come up with a prediction based on the wind, temperature and other things. So all hourly information is available. So we are also trying to develop a model to help you all as to what would be the price in next 24 hours or next 12 hours by giving a notice to you. It will help you to understand as to what will be the power shortage or surplus during any hour of the day.
Another thing that I wanted to just mention, that I didn't have the idea about how it is being conducted. Due to all that, at around 3:30 or so, you see the national grid, and whether it is the loading pattern and whether you have got delivery or not.
Yeah.
Supposing we have committed some amount of power,
yeah,
and it is because of the grid overloading,
yeah,
they are not able to take it. We know, supposing we have help from our side, not able to provide that, then they clause for penalty at all. Suppose that you have accepted that the grid will accept, but you can take the loan, but it is not able to take.
But yeah, there are two parts. So in the night, something happens. Having accepted the schedule at 6 o'clock, you have put in the schedule, and in the night, something happens. And because of that, you can't pump power. Something happens from the grid side, not from your side. In that case, it will be treated as a force majeure. Maybe there are no penalties. But at the daytime itself, at 2 o'clock, in NLC, you know that only 500 megawatt can go from south to north. And the demand for that side is 1000 megawatt. In that case, that 500 goes for the most expensive sellers, 500 megawatt sellers, they'll be locked out. And the cheaper 500 megawatt sellers are selected from southern zone or eastern zone or western zone. And they are selected, their prices are also reduced now because there is a area price arising out of congestion. In that case, it is known in advance only that you are not being selected or you are not coming in the shield. So there are two parts. One is before, one is after. Once you are in the schedule, then you have to fulfill your obligation, except for force majeure, which occurs because of RLDC or HLDC, some transmission line fails in the night, or there is a cyclone. But such cases are very, very few. You may say that those cases are 1 in 500 or 1 in 600 cases. In almost 500, 499 times, whatever is scheduled goes through.
Another thing, just a moment. You have given that bid based on some, our trader has placed some bid on behalf of us.
Yeah.
Are you able to update that or not? On the trader, someone that got under the net of update. Can we intervene and update that also?
Between 10 to 12, the trader who are having the terminal can change the prices as many times as possible or required. At 12 o'clock, there is a buzzer at the exchange closes. Thereafter, you can't make any change. And we are obliged to accept your request for changing the bid, but before 12.
Just one information.
Yeah.
This, whatever we are selling in the country, our transaction is going on, it is through IEC only. Is there any other grids to which we also deliver power?
There is a Power Exchange of India Limited, there is another exchange in that. But the trader, you can sell it to another trader or another buyer somewhere. Or you can also sell it, you are a generator, you can sell it to some consumer also directly. You can have a direct bilateral contract also. There is no need for your compulsion to come to the trader or compulsion to the come to the exchange. You are a free bird. Can operate wherever you are comfortable, depending on your skin, how to trade, that skin is important. How to put the price, that skin is also important. But if, I would suggest one simple thing, if you are a small generator, in that case you find out what is your best price. Don't bother about the market, whatever is your best price, it will be comfortable for you. You quote that so that you are selected on any day and you get a market price. Suppose you find that your best price is 3 rupees per kilowatt hour or 3,000 rupees per megawatt hour, same thing. Put that. If the market price is 5,000 rupees or 6,000 rupees or 3,200 rupees, you are selected and will get that price. So there is no loss. But suppose you expect price to be 5 rupees and the price will be 4,490, then your bid is not accepted and your power cannot be seen.
Is there a way out? Is that we got spend that power personally to pursue the electricity boards and they may be granted.
I can get you, can you take the mic and hear it your mouth? Again, ask the same question.
But I found that we are not able to trade and now CSE is taking power from us.
Yeah.
At quite cheap fixed prices.
Yeah.
So, can it be dual system?
It can be dual system, but you have to take with your CSEP, and fortunately for Chhattisgarh, your Regulatory Commission Chairman has initiated some changes and some measures by which you will see opening of the market in Chhattisgarh, and whatever profits they are taking at lower cost will be reduced, minimized. In fact, there was a conference recently, and in that conference we found that something could be done faster.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Any other question?
Sir, can you highlight something about the energy bank of future?
Energy?
Banks, like banks only deposit the money and whenever we need, we take it out. I am listening to producer of power.
Yeah.
Surplus power I will deposit in your bank.
Yeah.
And whenever I need, I my industry need, I will take it back. I don't want to do any exchange. Is there any future such type of things in coming days?
Yeah, we come up with this kind of product. Presently, this product is being utilized by the state electricity boards. They call it banking, energy banking. Then whenever there are surplus power, they give it to other state which is in need of that power. And when they need it, which is pre-appointed actually, I will give my power in December and I will take that power in the month of March. That is how they are making this kind of contract. But they are large contracts. We are trying to find out how we can address that issue and ensure that even the industries also will be allowed to do that. In fact, I was a member of Maharashtra Electricity Regulatory Commission, founder member. So in our order, we have said that the captive power plants can bank that energy for one year. If your state also, you can take it up with your regulators, show him cases like MERC and other cases, and ask him to give you the similar benefit of banking of your power with your SEB that will produce it in January and take it back in June or July or whenever you want it. Some kind of contract you can make and some kind of percentage, 5%, 10% surplus you can take. Similarly, if they are not in a position to give, what should be the liquidated damages to be given to you, which may be mostly market-based power prices. This kind of agreement can be made locally with the help of the regulator, or we will come out, we are thinking as to what kind of product trade is needing, that kind of product, if there are sufficient demands for such kind of product, we will come out with that kind of contract also over a period of time.